Hi friends, I hope you all are doing great. It's me, Nikki here, and I worked on another project this past weekend, and it was the cabinet in the small bathroom in my new office. And I get so many requests to do small space organization, and this was the perfect opportunity, and I love sharing these types of things. So let's get started. Okay friends, first let me share with you the space. It's your typical under cabinet in a small bathroom, and this is about apartment size for a lot of apartments. In my last house, we didn't even have this. So it is a little difficult with these types of spaces because of the plumbing, and you want to maximize the space, but plumbing gets in the way. So what I decided to do was find options that would work around the plumbing. And what I ended up doing was I actually am using office supplies. I'm using a magazine holder. I love it because it will work perfectly to house what I need to house, which is very minimal items, not too much. But the shape of it, you see that it has that slant. It's perfect because what it will allow me to do is slide it right in center where the plumbing is, and then it can kind of hide the plumbing a little bit, but still allow for me to put smaller things in the back and larger things up front. So now that I have my storage figured out, I needed to label everything. This is key with organization to keep it maintained. And I'm using these Martha Stewart book plates that I got from Staples. I love them because they match the other things that I installed in the bathroom, such as the toilet seat covers and the baskets and the paper towel dispenser. And so they're really affordable, really efficient. Now, one thing I want to say about labeling, one thing I encourage you to do is take that extra 5 minutes and use a level to make sure that your labels are on straight. Because sometimes when we go to label, we'll slap a sticker on there, a label on there, and it's not really even, and it really can affect the overall finished look, and you've worked hard on organizing it, so you want it to be beautiful also. So friends, now it's time to label each bin with what I'm going to put in that specific bin. And this is my handy dandy labeler that I've had for, I want to say right at 20 years, if not more now. It has stayed very close to me. I love it, and it's still working great. So now it's about deciding what I'm going to use for each bin and making sure that I label it appropriately. So I knew I wanted one for hand soap, cleaning items, personal items, and of course, first aid. So now that everything is labeled, it is time to organize it and put the things into each bin. And so the first bin is for hand soaps, and I stocked up from Target, 98-cent deal. These are normally $3.99, so I did jump on that to stock us up here in the office. I usually typically use the Grove, but I couldn't pass up this deal. But it gives us our hand soaps for the bathroom. We can easily get to it, and there could be no clutter as far as just things all over the place under the cabinet. Now the second one, this is for all of our cleaning supplies, and because it's a small bathroom, I need toilet bowl cleaner, disinfectant, and bathroom cleaner, keeping it simple, along with the toothbrush to clean around the sink. You all know how I love my cleaning toothbrushes, because a lot of times around the faucet you can't get in the crevices, so I love using a toothbrush, and of course you want to label it so that everyone knows how to use it. And then the next bin is for personal items that we may need around the office, and I found these cute little bags from Michaels, and they're great for sorting the things that I want to put in this section, such as feminine products in one, oral products and things in one. Another one is for body and hair products, and then we'll have a last one that is for like clothing and things like that. And then the last bin here is for our first aid kit, and I simply just purchased a first aid kit to stick right in there to keep it simple and tucked away, easy to get to. Now for our cleaning gloves and sponges, I have these clear acrylic little bins, containers rather, that I got from Target. I took the lids off so that we could easily get to them, and they're going to be tucked in the back of the cleaning portion of the cabinet so that when we pull out the cleaning bin, we can easily get to them, but they're tucked away and we're able to utilize that space. So simply by putting everything in, it's going to keep everything neat and orderly. But what's key is because there's no room to kind of throw things places and to make it messy, everything has a place. And then I have this spare on the side here that I really need because I have to store toilet paper. So I'm going to put the extra toilet paper tucked into the back. And then what I did was I went to Target and I found the perfect solution. This toilet paper dispenser was the perfect size to fit right in the side of the cabinet. So I love that about it because I could tuck it in and it fit perfectly without disrupting anything. I still could tuck extras in the back. And now we can easily get to our toilet paper along with all of the other items. And what I love about the magazine holders is basically like to get to things that we need to get to easily. We don't really have to pull it out. You simply can just pull it down and get to the first aid kit and all of the other items. So it's really neat and efficient. Again, it will help us all keep it neat under here because you can only put things where they go. There's no room to sit anything on the side. It just keeps things neat and orderly, but you can clearly get to what you need to get to. So friends, I hope you enjoyed going on this journey with me to transform this cabinet to our perfect organized little space here in the office. Please definitely let me know how you like it. If you have any questions, I would love to hear from you. Have a beautiful day, my friends. I will see you at the next video. And this is Nikki saying goodbye.